That will do it. Tremendous statement on opening night for the Atlanta Hawks. A rout at home, 113-87. Atlanta defeats Dallas.
You know, it was our first game. You know, we got a new coach, a lot of new coaching staff, two new players. We'll be fine, you know, but today was a terrible game. We couldn't make nothing. You know, we got 81 to go, so we have to do one.
And after a season opening loss, Dallas will finish up this first road trip of the year 50-50. 103-95. It's a winner for the Mavericks on the road against the Toronto Raptors.
Always feels good to get your first win, especially after the first loss that they got in Atlanta.
There's nothing like the home opener in any sport, and so we've been a part of one on the road, and now we get to have ours here at home, and so we're excited to be playing in front of our fans.
New year, big expectations, not just on the Mavs as a whole, but especially on 77.
No doubt, number one, happy to be down here on the court again, but for number 77, this is the beginning of how we're going to tell his story, right? You look back 10 years from now, you go, fourth year, man. You got to get out of the second round if you're going to be one of the greats. And this is the beginning of it. The home opener right here, American Airlines Center.
Yeah, and he's MVP favorite, so there's pressure on J-Kid, Nico, Q, yeah. KP, the whole, all 15 guys on the roster to help put that guy in position to succeed.
Yeah. Right?
And if they can do that, he can take them where they want to go.
Everyone knows who that dude is and knows he's the MVP favorite. So being the front runner, it sounds silly. It's really tough. It's a really tough thing.
They're kind of adopting that mentality anyway, right? Like, yep. They want to become one of the hunted, not one of the hunters anymore. In order to do that, like you said, you got to win series, but you also got to win home games.
Absolutely.
Last year, too many home losses. Year before, too many home losses. Yep. Tonight's the home opener against a team that they should beat.
Right.
What are we talking about when we talk Rockets?
I mean, you think about the great games we played against the James Harden era Rockets, even further back, the Hakeem and Clyde Drexler Rockets. But for me, this year's about Luka. And the origin of Hallaluka was against the Rockets. And that was one of the nights where we thought, well, we got some magic here, right?
The legend was born.
Yeah, 11 straight points. Wasn't having a great game up until that point. And then they stood up there and they sang Hallaluka for him. And it was really weird and kind of awkward. And then the man went insane. So I love playing the Rockets. I love an in-state rivalry.
Let me talk. Thank you. I would say welcome everybody back to the building. We are really excited to have you guys. Thank you for coming, and go Mavs!
Luka!
Well, you know, Luka loves getting those.
He did it against Delano Banton the other night.
Give it to Steve, right?
Reggie Bullock.
Nice to see. Oh, that's a pure.
And here's a score inside. A hard fall. Oh, that's a foul and a score for Jalen Brunson. So there's Bullock sidestepping the defense and connecting from long reach again. Leading scorer for Dallas, Cleveland with 9. Luka has 8. Boban has 7. Jalen Brunson leads an assist with 7. Top rebounder is Luka with 6. And against Dallas, their first lead since 4-2.
You'd like to have gotten off to a better start than that, but they sort of worked through it and found a little something in the first half.
Yeah, I mean, they rolled through the roster pretty quick, right? And just kept going to the bullpen. Coach Kidd kept running out there, next guy, and eventually you got all of them out there.
It's a really cool thing, right? Because we talk about team sports. And to have all 15 play, and it's a beautiful thing, the chemistry and accountability that we've talked about from day one.
You did what you're supposed to do against a team that you're better than. You really saw tonight what it looks like when a team plays the Dallas Mavericks that has no answer for Luka Doncic on their roster.
Yeah, Jae'Sean Tate gave him some trouble in the first half, but Luka got him in foul trouble, which is nice.
Right.
And then it's a bunch of younger wings, and then Eric Gordon, who's kind of a smaller player. Gordon was playing great on offense, but they just, like you said, they didn't have anything to stop Luka, which is important because KP missed basically the entire second half. Other guys pitched in, Reggie Bullock, Tim Hardaway Jr., in particular, Jalen Brunson, career high tying 11 assists.
Distributing the basketball tonight was phenomenal. I think he can be their third, fourth best player. Obviously a contract year for him. Incentive to play well, incentive to get his body to the degree where he doesn't get played off the court physically in playoff series. But loved what he brought tonight. They really, really need that kind of guy. And you saw the second half, man. He jumped out, 12-0 run, put him in the rearview mirror, said, you know what? We're a better team than y'all. We'll see y'all next time. You're gonna do the same exact thing. You have no answer for Luka in the second half. And yeah, awesome. Awesome home opener.